Learn Excel from Mr. Excel Podcast, episode 1796, High Columns in the Excel Web App. Hey, welcome back to the Mr. Excel Netcast. I'm Bill Jelen. Today's question sent in by Dalia. Dalia saw a post about the Excel Interactive View that I've covered here on the podcast before, but Dalia wants to do something that Excel Interactive View can't do. Dalia wants to be able to hide certain columns. She has years going across here, and how can we filter by columns? And boy, the interactive view doesn't do that. But here's my idea, and it's rather convoluted. So here's our years going across and the data that we want to present on the web. First thing we have to do is this data is built incorrectly. We have to build it correctly. So I'm going to do Alt+D P to get back to the old pivot table and pivot chart wizard. This is the Mike Alexander trick for unwinding data, multiple consolidation ranges. I'm going to create the page fields and specify our data set here. Click Finish. All right, that gets us the exact same data, but it's in a pivot table. I need to double-click the grand total, which will unwind the data that had been going across to make it go down. Now, we have to change these the headers here. So this is indicator, this is year, and this is value. Now, the trick that we're ultimately going to do, putting the data out on the Excel web app, this kind of a pivot table, multiple consolidation range, does not work on the Excel web app. Now that we've gotten the results over on sheet 3, we can delete this one because it's no longer necessary. In fact, we could even delete this one and just be left with this data here. Now from here, we're going to insert a pivot table. This will be the real pivot table that we ultimately show. We want years going across, indicator going down, and why is my field list so small, I wonder? The value here, all right, indicator going down, there we go. All right, grand totals are not necessary here, so we come back to the design tab, grand totals, off for rows and columns. I hate the headings column labels and row labels, let's replace that with something useful. Show in tabular form, under report layout, we'll do that. All right, do we need rows 1 and 2? No, we can delete those. And then finally, while we're inside the pivot table, we go to the Analyze tab. That was the Options tab in Excel 2010. We're going to insert a slicer for year, like that. Okay, let's format the slicer a little bit. We could go to multiple columns here, but I'm just going to make it smaller. Choose a nice color, whatever color you would like. Okay, so we now have a situation where we can filter based on the columns. So you can choose one column or you can choose a series of columns and have that data appear. All right, so our spreadsheet is working well. Let's save this spreadsheet, but we're not going to save it to our computer. We're going to do File, Save As, save it to the SkyDrive, the public folder on SkyDrive, and let's just call it Hide Years Take 2. I actually tested it before the podcast. That's rare for me. Usually I turn on the recorder and go, but this time I wanted to make sure that it would work. Okay, so we have it saved out there to the SkyDrive, and File, Share. We want to get a sharing link, and even the view will work. Anyone with a view link can view this document, create the link. Boy, and it creates a horrible link. No one wants to be able to type that in. If you were actually going to share this, you would want to use a URL shortener to shorten it, but for right now, I'll just copy that whole thing, Control C. We will go to that place, Control V. All right, so now anyone who has that link should be able to come in, see this data. It's in a web page. We don't need the pivot table field list, and they can choose 1 year, or the next year, or the next year, or even click and drag to get a series of years. Or maybe they need 2009, and then Control-click 2013, and it will show that data. So here we are in a browser doing kind of what the Excel Interactive View would do, but it's letting us filter the columns instead of filtering the rows. Well, hey, my thanks to Dalia and also to Oz Desolay. Oz had originally published the story about the Excel Interactive View that I saw this question posted on. So thanks to Oz. Check out his great website at datascopic.net. And I want to thank you for stopping by. We'll see you next time for another Netcast from Mr. Excel.